Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. In this episode, I'm gonna try to prove to you that constructors don't actually exist. Stick around. Now, I know that this seems like a silly thing to say because, of course, you call constructors all the time. But I'm going to convince you, I hope, that you are not actually calling constructors, and I just want you thinking about the language in a slightly more deep way. Well, that's the whole point of this channel, really, is to make you think about C++ in new ways. And of course, before we move on, make sure you check out the video description at the bottom of this video for links to the notes about this particular episode and perhaps any other relevant information, such as buying one of my t-shirts. All right, so here we go. I'm going to create a constructor. Pretty straightforward. And I'm going to create a destructor. Now remember, don't create empty destructors just for the fun of it. That is incredibly wasteful and it doesn't help your code in any useful way whatsoever. It is here for illustrative purposes and some sort of helper function. Now, if I want a pointer to this helper function, I can declare that with a member function pointer syntax, and it is by far not easy to read, but it looks something like this. And I can create an object of type S. And then I can use the member function pointer syntax to call this get function here. And while this might seem overly complicated, and it is, it points out that we can have member function pointers. And these things could even be reassigned. And so you can do interesting things like have perhaps a vector of member function pointers and call a bunch of different member function pointers on a bunch of different objects. I don't know, whatever. It's up to your imagination here. And once we have an object of type S, it is possible to explicitly call the destructor. Now we also can't get a pointer to the destructor because a destructor doesn't have a return type. So it even says right here, taking address of destructor. That's not allowed. If we wanted to try to turn this around and say, take an address of a constructor, there's really no way to even reason about this. I can attempt to, like this, but it does say, warning, taking error of constructor. And there's simply like no way to call a constructor directly. I cannot in any way create a pointer to it or explicitly call one, and I will explain why. Let's say I want to make this a template that takes an integer. So now when I create one of these, I have to have an integer parameter to it. And I just want to give a shout out to Ben Dean for even pointing this particular example out to me. And there's really just no way to do this. I don't have any way of saying, I really want you to take this particular constructor from this type and call it. This syntax doesn't exist. We can, of course, use templated constructors, but we have to do something like this and use member function template type deduction. And I can pass this 42, and now it's a constructor that took a type of integer. Now, if you think I'm wrong here and actually have a way of calling this constructor directly without needing to pass it a parameter, go ahead and post that here, but I am almost 100% certain that that is not possible. Let's clean this up. So we are right here creating an object of type S, immediately throwing it away because we did not give it a name, that takes an integer. Now, this is not technically a constructor call. Now, I am absolutely willing to be proven wrong here, but it is my understanding that this falls under the rules of explicit type conversion with functional notation. It's also a function style cast. It takes a braced init list or an expression list that constructs a value of the specified type given the initializer. So that's what we're looking at here. We're actually looking at a cast. A cast, you say? A cast from 42 to an object of type S, and it finds this constructor in the process. To prove the point, I will demonstrate this, which looks like a reinterpret cast, which would be undefined behavior, but it is not. This is just another way of invoking the explicit construction of an object of type S from a value of 42. Now, this one has the distinct disadvantage that there's no way to do this conversion with more than one parameter. We could do this, maybe. Nope. Comma operator is coming into effect, so this has no use. But we can do that. We can also do the explicitly named static cast from an integer to an object of type S. And just in case you don't believe me about this working like it does, I am going to use standard string to illustrate a point. We can see here that 16 is returned from main exactly like expected. This is not a reinterpret cast. This is just another way of invoking an explicit conversion from a const character literal to a standard string. Now, I would state that I strongly recommend that you not use this syntax because it is not good. And we can easily make this go awry by doing this, which is actually a reinterpret cast from a pointer to a const character literal to a pointer of string, and then we get something very, very wrong from the compiler in this case. So I did have a C++ weekly request for an episode about this topic, plus it overlapped with an episode that I had already been planning to do. So again, don't do this syntax, please. But be aware that there are ways of invoking constructors and that you don't think of, and that constructors themselves are not really functions. They don't really exist. They are conversion operators from a set of parameters to a type. An interesting look into the C++ language, I think. Be sure to stick around, and I will see you in next week's episode.